Hello everyone, Alexander Flores here. In this tutorial, we're going to be going over how our users can change their password. And this is assuming that they are logged in, so this is not a forgot password flow, which is something different. This is a setting you might include in your user dashboard where they currently know their password, but they wish to change it to something else. So in this video and the next couple of videos, we're going to be creating a settings dashboard with a couple similar features to this as well. So we're going to start things off by creating a settings.js component. Inside here, we're simply going to import React and render a very basic component. We're then going to import this settings file into our app file. And we're going to go ahead and render settings right at the bottom here. Now, obviously, our website, if you've been following the series, just has a lot of stuff stacked on top of it. And that's because we're not trying to create a functional dashboard or focus on the styling at all. We are only focusing on the Cognito logic. Obviously, the exact implementation will be different for every one of your guys' applications, and you can then take the logic that you're learning from these videos and apply it however you see best fit that looks better and flows better for the user experience inside of your own applications. So we're going to go back to our code, and inside of settings, we're going to go ahead and import use context. Our goal here is to only display the settings whenever we're actually logged in. So we're going to import account context from accounts, and then we're going to use the use context hook inside of our render function. So now that we've imported both these things, we're going to go ahead and access the get session function from within our account context using the use context hook. We now want to be able to call this whenever our component mounts, and to do that with hooks, we need the use effect hook. We can go ahead and use this right here. So this code here will run whenever our component mounts and no other time. So this is a good time to call get session. So get session returns a promise, so we're going to go ahead and use .then to listen to whenever we are logged in. Alternatively, .catch will be ran whenever we are not logged in. And if that's the case, if this is on an actual user dashboard, we might want to redirect them to a login screen or make a login pop-up occur right then. However, for now, we're simply just going to set something in state that says, hey, this user is logged in. So to do that, we need to import the use state hook. And then using use state, we're going to go ahead and keep track if we're logged in or not. Now inside of getSessions.then, we can go ahead and say set logged in true. And now inside of everything here, we're going to go ahead and wrap this inside of a check to make sure logged in is true. So this code here will simply say if logged in is true and this is true, and this is always true, so it will simply just be rendered. So what we're going to do with this essentially is say only render this JSX element here if logged in is true. And we're simply going to have a React fragment here to allow us to have multiple things inside of here, which we'll add soon. For now, let's go ahead and save this. We go back to our website. So it says settings here, which means that we are logged in, and we see with our status.js file, which we made on a previous video, we also see that we're logged in. We can go ahead and log out, and currently there's nothing to refresh. Obviously, in your own applications, you want to add that functionality. However, we can go ahead and refresh right here, and it simply says, please log in below when we do not see the settings. So if we log in again using the credentials, again, this is our test account that I created on the very first Cognito video. And a quick note, a link to a playlist with all of the Cognito videos I'm making will be in the top link in the description. So we can go ahead and click on login. So it says we're logged in, and again, we have to refresh. And now we see you are logged in and we see the settings here. So below the settings H1 here, we're actually going to go through and make a form that'll allow our users to change their password. Now this is just a general settings file, and I plan to add more features to this in the coming videos, such as how to change your email and things like that. So we're going to go ahead and make another file called change password, which we will import into our settings file. Additional features, like I mentioned, like change email, will also be imported in this way. That way we only have to do this logic of rendering these settings whenever we're logged in, just in this one file. So we'll go ahead and make a new file, changepassword.js. We're going to go ahead and import React and return a basic component. We can go ahead and import this into our settings and then render it. So now if we go ahead and save everything, we should see this component of change password rendered because we're logged in. And we see that right here. So now we're going to go ahead and make a form right here. So inside this form, we're going to do a couple things. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to create an onSubmit function, and we're simply just going to cancel the event. So inside of this function, later on, we're going to go ahead and actually change the user's password. But for now, we're just going to leave it as is. We can create a couple inputs in here, but before that, we need access to state so these inputs will actually work. So we can go ahead and import the use state hook. And we're going to need two pieces of information from the user here. their current password and their new password. You could add in a confirm new password if you want to. However, that's up to you to do. For now, we're just gonna do their current password and their new password. Now we can go ahead and create a couple input fields and a submit button. So from here, we use a very similar input field setup to our login component before. We're not gonna add any placeholders or anything like that. We're keeping things very basic. We're simply gonna have the value be equal to the password. And then on change, we're gonna go ahead and set the password equal to whatever the new text is. Same exact thing with the new password. And then this button here is simply going to submit the form, which we then call the onSubmit function. So to make sure everything's working, we can simply console log our password and our new password for testing purposes. Go ahead and save this file and we'll try it out. So under settings, we can make our old password, we'll be able to say test, and this one will be test 2. We can change the password and we see that those are correctly logged, so everything's working fine. Going back to our code, we can now go ahead and start doing the Cognito side of things that will be actually resetting or changing the password. So we're going to want to access the get session method from our account context. So we're going to have to import use context and the account context. And then we're going to access the get session method through object destructuring when using these two together. Now, whenever we're submitting our form, we're going to go ahead and call get session. This promise returns a session whenever it resolves, so we can go ahead and console log this and see what we get. We're also going to get rid of this console log now that we know that that works, and we can go ahead and save this and see what happens. So if we simply just click on change password, we're going to see our session here. So inside here we see a couple different tokens, however these aren't directly useful to us right now. We're mostly looking for the email address for the account, and the email address is actually stored inside of an attribute. If we go ahead and open up the Cognito console, so if we select the correct Cognito user pool, in this case tutorial, and we go to our users and we select our user, we see some stuff here, such as the sub and the email, but also if we go over to attributes, we see some of these attributes here, and if they were custom attributes, we can see those as well. So in order for us to get some more meaningful information in this exact use case, we need to have the get session method gain access to these attributes. This would be a common thing we see within Cognito. Whenever we're wanting to gain access to if the user is logged in, we might also want to gain access to the sub of that user, which is the unique ID, as well as the email. And so we're going to modify the get session method real quick to return that information. So if there's not an error, we're going to call user.getAttributes, and this is going to be inside of a promise, and the end result is going to be resolving a combined object with the session tokens as well as the Cognito user attributes. So first we're going to create an attributes variable and set it equal to the return of a promise. And then we're going to say user.getAttributes. And this simply is going to return a callback that either returns an error or the attributes. Now if there is an error, we're simply going to log it and then reject. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the attributes. Now inside of the last resolve, which goes for our original promise, we're going to go ahead and spread these two objects together, and this will return one singular object that has both of them inside. We can go ahead and save this, and currently, if we go over to our settings, or not settings, we can go to change password, we're console logging our session. And it seems like I have an error. Okay, this needs to be an asynchronous function, so right here needs to be asynchronous. That should fix that. So going back to our change password, we're console logging the session. So now if we go back to our application, we see a session here. And we see that these are not exactly in the correct format that we want. If we really wanted them to be inside of an object that said email colon test at test.com, and similar for the sub and email verified. So we're going to go ahead and change that real quick. So inside here, instead of resolving attributes directly, we're going to create another variable called results. And we're simply going to resolve results. And then we're going to loop through the attributes and create a proper object that is more user-friendly to us. So now that we're looping through all of them, we're going to use object destructuring to gain access to the name and the value. And then we're simply going to put this inside of the results object. So results with the property of whatever name is now going to equal value, and that's what we're resolving. So again, real quick, all this code, including all of our previous Cognito episodes, will be in the description in its own GitHub repository. So if you just want to copy this section because it's not directly related to changing passwords, go ahead and do that. It could save you some time. We can go ahead and save this file and see if it works. So here, because we're getting session whenever the settings is rendered, we can go ahead and look at this, and we see that email, sub, email verified, and all the tokens are right there in the same object. So now, going back over here, we can destructure this to just gain access to our email. And now we're gonna actually authenticate the user and then change the password. So in order to change the password, we have to authenticate, and that's one of the reasons why we moved our authenticate method into the account context here. So we can import it into this file and to log in and to other things. So we can go ahead and use this just like we're using on get session here. So before we actually authenticate, I'm gonna try and change the password without authenticating to show you what happens. We can go ahead and get rid of this console log. We can be pretty confident that email is gonna hold the correct email now. And then we wanna gain access to the user. There's a couple ways we can do this. Like one way is to import the user pool and call userpool.getCurrentUser. However, we could just return the user inside of the session, the quote-unquote session that we're returning now. So we are making a couple changes to this right here. We also could just return the user. And so this user is going to be the current user, as we see right here, pool.getCurrentUser. So we're just going to return that as well. So going back over here, we can destructure the user and email. And now we can say user.changePassword. So change password requires two arguments. The first one is the current password. The second one is the new password. And then technically it does return a callback. Similar to most other Cognito functions, it has an error and then the actual result. So we can go ahead and enter our password, our new password. And then our callback. And we're simply just going to console log these results. So if we go ahead and save this, also make sure to save all the other files if you haven't. Going back to our application, we can go ahead and enter our current password, which is password 1, and our new password, which will be password 2. If we try and change the password, we are going to see success here because we're already logged in. So if I go ahead and log out, and then I refresh, now if I try and log in with the old credentials, and I click on login, we're going to get an incorrect username or password exception. However, if I change this to 2, we can log in, and now we see that we're logged in correctly. If I refresh, we'll see the rest of the settings. So now going back to our code, we gain access to this email, and we need to be able to authenticate just in case the user isn't logged in. We don't want to send them to a login form just to log in and then have to do the same thing again. So we have access to their email and to their supposed current password. And so we can try logging them in right here and then changing the password, which in some cases could make it more user-friendly for your users. So if we go back to our account file and we go down to authenticate, we see that we need to pass in a username, which is our email, and our password. So we can simply go back here and we can authenticate. And so we're going to use .then, which assumes that everything went well, and we're just going to move this code into this function. So if we go back to account, we see that on failure, we're going to go ahead and reject. So this is fine to put this here. We can go ahead and save this. And then going back, so our current password is password 2. We can change that back to the default here. So now it should be password 1 once we change password. And we see that it's success, and we see on success as well because we authenticated again. So this isn't technically required, as you saw previously before I implemented this, it still worked. However, in some use cases where your users can still see that field, maybe they're not logged in at the moment, maybe a cookie expired or something like that, it might be a little bit more user-friendly to assume that we can log them in. And if they are entering an incorrect original password, for example, in this use case, it was password 2 before we just changed it, then you're going to be thrown an exception anyway, so this isn't any security problems. So that's it for this video, just simply how to change your user's password inside of a settings. In the next video, we're going to be going over how to change your user's email. A link to all Cognito videos will be in the description, as well as all the code for this. If you have any questions or you have any video ideas, leave them below in the comments, and consider liking and subscribing if this video helped. Thanks for watching.